get started developing with Node.js, you'll need to have Node.js installed on your local machine. That's the only real requirement, but there are a couple of things that you can do in order to make this experience better. In this tutorial, we'll explain the Node.js release cycle, which will help you figure out the version or versions of Node.js that you should work with. We'll also recommend the best way to get Node.js installed onto your local machine, as well as some other things to consider when developing locally with Node.js. Before you go to install Node.js, it's important to understand which versions you have to choose from and how each version relates to the overall release schedule. Node.js is always getting better and always being worked on, and as a result, there's a new major version released every 6 months. When you go to install Node.js, you'll have plenty of different versions to choose from. You're likely to see versions referred to as current, long-term support, or LTS, and maintenance LTS. The long-term support, or LTS release, is the most stable release, which is best suited for production environments. An LTS release is considered to be stable software. While it is still considered an active LTS release, it'll receive security updates, critical bug fixes, and some non-breaking new features. Although a new version of Node.js comes out every 6 months, only the even-numbered versions are destined to become LTS releases. The latest version of Node.js available at any time is typically called the current version. The current version will have new features added to it as they become available. Because the current release is being actively worked on, it may get experimental features that might change over time, and it's not considered to be particularly stable. Here's a chart of the Node.js release schedule created by Tierney Siren in NodeSource, which might help you understand it a little bit better. If you look at the second line on the chart, you can see the lifecycle of an LTS. A new active LTS is cut every October, and then it's supported in an active LTS capacity for 18 months. At that point, the LTS enters maintenance LTS and is supported for another 12 months. A maintenance LTS will only get critical bug fixes, but it won't have any new features brought to it. And after the 12-month period, the maintenance LTS will be considered end of life, and it will no longer be supported. I'll admit, it can be a little bit confusing. So you might be asking, which version should I use? My simple answer is, use whatever the active LTS is at this time. You can find that out by going to the Node.js.org website. It should tell you whatever the active LTS is currently. I recommend using the active LTS instead of the most current version, because active LTS is really what you should be running in production, and so I think personally, that's what you should also be running to develop against locally. With different versions of Node to choose from, and several floating around and supported at any given time, it makes sense that you might actually want to be using multiple versions of Node.js on your system. Luckily, there's a great tool which is not only the best way to install Node.js for local development, but also allows you to switch between any version of Node that you want. It's called, appropriately enough, NVM, Node Version Manager. NVM is indispensable if you're ever working with applications which are locked to a specific older version of Node.js. NVM allows you to install versions of Node and switch between them whenever you want. You can learn more about NVM in our tutorial about using it to install Node.js. Another consideration when developing locally with Node.js is how to manage your environment variables. When you're in development, your application will typically use different environment variable values than your production application will. We recommend using a .env file to hold all of your environment variables when you're developing locally. You can then use the package .env in order to load them. You can learn more about that from our tutorial about setting up and using a .env file. To recap, in this tutorial, we talked about the Node.js release cycle and the different kinds of releases such as active LTS, maintenance LTS, and the current release. We talked about why you should use an active LTS in production, and also recommended that you use it for your local development as well. Overall, we talked about some of the considerations when setting up your local development environment, such as making sure you're using the right version of Node.js, managing those versions, as well as how to manage your environment variables.